Overwhelms the body with something called sepsis. You become quite ill. kills around 300 million people in the 20th century alone, before vaccination campaigns eradicate the disease. Now, we may be safe from infection, but the virus itself is still alive and well. And it may not even have to be turned into a weapon to kill us.
There are at least two locations we know for sure they still have the virus. In the United States, at the Center for Prevention, and in the Russian biolab in Siberia. But it's very possible others could have. We found out that the laboratories at the NIH had an old freezer that had old specimens with smallpox virus in that we knew about.
The virus is held for research purposes, and some fear it has the makings of a global disaster.
The fear, of course, is the virus somehow escaping from the lab into some new state. There have been ethical debates and a great deal of fighting over scientists who are studying very pathogenic, very infectious, very dangerous microbes. As a scholar, as a pursuer of knowledge, I'm always in favor of research. I'm only in favor of research on these highly dangerous viruses by the best experts in the class.
But it's possible that a wannabe bioterrorist might not even need a physical sample of the virus. They simply need the genetic blueprint.
A side debate of researching highly pathogenic microbes, which should you publish if
there
Sir? No, sir, she brought it in.